Hi, everybody. I'm David Feingold, and I'm honored to serve as the 19th president of Chatham University. It's really welcome. It's really a great pleasure to welcome all of you to join our community. We're so excited to have you here. Yesterday was a great deal of fun. I hope you sensed the energy and excitement on campus in helping all of you and your families to move in and feel part of our community. You're joining Chatham at a really exciting time. We just opened our brand new dining hall in Anderson. We've selected an architecture firm that's going to put in a new wing to the science building right here on this quad, right between Buell and Welker. We have one of the fastest growing universities in all of Pennsylvania over the last decade, and we're really excited about what's happening in terms of adding to the diversity of the campus, the national reach of the campus. I've just got a couple of asks of you. I know this has been a packed first few hours for you at Chatham, but one is just to get involved. Join some student organizations, find ways to make new friends and get engaged on campus. And if you don't find the organization you're looking for, find a few friends and start your own. That's how many of our best student organizations have got kicked off. I'd also really encourage you to take advantage of the great city that you're in here in Pittsburgh. For those who are from outside of the city, so much going on here, whether it's culture, outdoor activities, sports activities, lots of opportunities for you to get engaged. And I'm pleased to announce a new one we just had. So any of you who would like to go to a Pitt football game, they've extended it so that you can get the same tickets that Pitt students do to go. So if you want to go to a game this fall, that opportunity will be there. The other thing I'd ask of you is, it's tough to get to know so many new names all at once, but when you see me walking around campus, or you see my wife Sue, she's about 5 foot, not much more than that, short haircut, very posh British accent. If you see us walking around campus, we've got the campus dog, Louie, who's very, very friendly. And so please stop, pet him, introduce yourself. Even if we've met briefly, don't hesitate to say who you are again till we get everyone's names down. But we would really love to get to know all of you. It's now my great pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker today, Dr. Kathy Elliott. Kathy is a great friend of Chatham, an alum of Chatham, got her Doctor of Nursing Practice here. She is a trustee of the university, and as you'll hear from her, she leads a very successful nonprofit organization called Gwen's Girls, as well as heading up the Black Girls Equity Alliance. And she's been a key advisor for Mayor Ganey as he has come in as Pittsburgh's first African-American mayor. So we're very proud to celebrate Kathy, and please join me in giving her a warm Chatham welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Feingold. It is truly an honor and privilege to be here to speak to you all on your orientation few days. You all look amazing. I was so surprised when students started coming in. You all just started walking down to the front. I thought I was going to have to stand up here and say, please come down. But the ladies came down and sat in front. And so you all look like you're ready to learn and that you're ready to be a part of a campus that is about engaging and learning and being social and really about change, right? There's a lot of things that are occurring in our society. You all have been through a lot through your high school years, and now you're embarking on a college career, educational track, and so please, if you don't learn anything else from this talk, take advantage of the opportunities that are around you on this campus. Learn from one another. Learn from your faculty. And so one of the things that I wanted to start to talk about is, like, why Chatham? Why did I choose Chatham? And I want to hear from you all about why you chose Chatham. But one of the main reasons that I chose Chatham, and it wasn't until I, you know, he wasn't here when I came to Chatham, but the faculty here at Chatham are very open. And as you just heard from the president of the university, I don't know any other universities that you would be able to, you know, hear from the very beginning, but really mean that when you see him walking and you see him at a game and or you see him in a dining hall, to come up and say something to him. A lot of universities, I went to a bigger university here in Pittsburgh, and although I was able to make connections, it wasn't until I was, you know, graduated and in my profession that I really was able to connect. But I believe that here, the faculty, as well as the administration, is open. So remember that. If you have an issue or just want to, you know, think about different activities or things that you all want to do, they are open to hear about that. So, as Dr. Feingold mentioned, I graduated with my doctorate in nursing practice in 2014. And so with that, I have many different degrees, as you will see. I have my MSW, and then I have MSN, and I'm a psychiatric nurse practitioner. So you probably, people talk about lifelong learners. I'm really not that, but there was certain goals that I had that I knew that I wanted to pursue. So early on in my, you know, when I was in high school, I knew that I wanted to help people. I also was intrigued about the brain, like why and behavior. Why do people do what they do? And so it was after just learning about different professions and learning about different opportunities that led me into wanting to pursue nursing. But then I also wanted to be a therapist, so psychiatric nursing only made sense to me. But it was also, you know, the pursuit of trying to really understand the practice of helping people and really being impactful in the work that I do. So I say all that to say that you all are just starting out on your journey. And so take advantage of all the opportunities that you can to learn about whatever profession you may want to be in. You may be surprised. And even your classmates, people that are sitting next to you, they're pursuing things maybe that you may not have thought about. Listen to them, learn from them. That is what this is all about. It's not about book learning. And one of the things that we wanted to do in this talk, and it kind of turned out that way, but that this is not to be a lecture. I wanted it to be more engaging, but in the space that we're in, you know, it's hard for you all to move because I was going to actually have y'all stand up and do some activities, but we still going to have a little bit of fun in a few minutes. But take advantage of learning from one another. Take advantage of the experiences that you will learn across this city of Pittsburgh. Good, bad, and indifferent. You'll experience different things that may not be what you set out to do, but any type of learning to me is worthwhile. So take advantage of that. So again, why Chatham? There's many core values that Chatham has, and so I want to ask you all, who knows, who can name, there's four core values of Chatham. Who can raise their hand and tell us one? Anybody? Absolutely. Thank you. So come on up here. You get a gift card. It's a $25 gift card for you. Yeah. I got your attention now, huh? So come on. Wait. Bringing up sustainability, because that has become one of the main things that I know. Y'all see your hand going up now. When I asked, you was slow to put it up there.
I'm sorry. I just want to get that gift card.
I know you do. You have a you will. You have a chance. Give me a minute. So sustainability. That's one of the things that we, you know, have taken pride in over these past few years at Chatham, because in 2014, as you all probably have heard, we opened up the Eaton Hall campus. And again, when you have an opportunity to drive out there or ride out there and see the campus, please do, because it is a gem, not only in, you know, unfortunately it's not in our city, but it's in our county, it's, you know, in our region, and it's a space that you really can learn about, you know, how we need to be treating our environment and just having a sustainable campus, but also just environment in general. So thank you. So he had his hand up like about 3 minutes ago. So let's go. I'll get you.
Yeah, gender equity.
Yes, it is. Yes, come on down. But there's a little bit before that. What comes before gender equity? So the women's leadership and gender equity core value, there is a lot of work. And as you all know, Chatham was built upon just being a women's college and really focused on women's rights and everything that had to do with promoting and empowering women in our world, because it's not even just our region. But there are several departments that you all need to get familiar with, because folks that may not even attend Chatham and that are a part of community really look to and partner with these different departments, because they have such impact and power and leadership in the work that happens in our region. The first is the Center for Women's Entrepreneurship, and that is, in and of itself, the title says it all. It helps women who are pursuing business and wanting to understand how to start a business and then connect with folks that can help to promote their business and just all those different aspects. And so you all need to get involved with that. Also, the Pennsylvania Center for Women in Politics. This is a tremendous asset to our region. They partner with folks that, I was going to say like me, but I've been trying to avoid politics. And so, in Pittsburgh, there's a lot of things that are happening, and I didn't talk about the work that I do, and I'll get to that in a minute, but a lot of folks, you know, ask me about running for different things, and so I'm like, yeah, not yet. But if I did, this center is where I would come, because they help you learn all about campaigning and all the different networking things that you need to do and things that you need to know around politics. So if you are interested in that type of work, this is definitely the center for you. And then last but surely not least is the Women's Institute, which is the hub for the leadership and women's equity work that happens. I happen to be a good friend with Dr. Jesse Ramey, who runs that. And so, you know, it is, again, all three of these different entities are vital to the work that happens in our region, not only just around women, but in around equity in general. So you all take advantage of what you have as a student here at Chatham, because you're like front and center with these faculty, as well as you'll see different events that'll happen on campus or that you will be invited to. Take advantage of that. Okay. I'm gonna have to go to him. He, go ahead. Yep, so come on up. So diversity inclusion, this is, I'm going to get into this portion a little bit more as I you know, wrap up my slides. I only had a few minutes. I have another gift card that I'm going to give away, but I just want to say that the diversity inclusion is a space that I think every campus, every entity, every, you know, business is looking at how we can do a better job in being more inclusive. And the only way that we can do that here on Chatham's campus is with each one of you, right? Because you all came in with your different experiences, your different backgrounds, your different, you know, learning opportunities that you had. There's so many different things that make us different, but I challenge you all to talk to one another and to engage with one another to learn the similarities, because that's where the strength comes in. So on campus, there's several different opportunities for you to get involved. First, I want to highlight that the RISE, which is a retreat for students of color, that will happen in early September, and the deadline is September 2nd. So you all need to, if you fit within that category, you need to sign up for to attend that, because again, you will have an opportunity to learn how to engage and to teach us, not even just you learn, but you teach those that are on this campus how we can be more inclusive. All right, there's one more. I'm gonna go right here with the Rugrats. Is that what it says? Say it again? Absolutely, come on down. So community engagement. So it's at this point that I'm going to tell you a little bit about the work that I do and invite each and every one of you to get engaged. I have the mic and the platform, even those, I forgot we were live streaming. Hello, live stream people, and hi up there up top. I have an opportunity to tell you all about an organization that I run. I have been blessed and fortunate to be able to carry my mother's legacy. She was in the first class of women police to serve here in the city of Pittsburgh. And her name was Gwen Elliott, and she served 26 years on the police force. And during her tenure, she came across a lot of youth and families, and particularly girls, and particularly black girls, who were disproportionately either sent to, we had a detention center, they closed it recently, Schumann Center, and then we also had a center for child welfare kids that were being removed from the home for like neglect, but it was mostly running away. And so there really wasn't anything in the community that was specifically for girls that she was able to refer them to, and not to the system. And unfortunately, that is something that we're still fighting, the overrepresentation of black youth in our criminal justice and child welfare system. So if you are someone that is interested in, or you know, after spending some time on campus and want to get interested in social justice, we have work for you, and work for you to engage with us. So she started a organization, it's entitled Gwen's Girls, and we primarily work in the after-school setting with girls from ages 8 through 18. We are in three communities within Allegheny County, which is the county that we're in for folks that are from out of town. And so we have been like really looking at how can we better educate, educate not only our young people, but our systems about the policies and practices that inherently predispose them to the criminal justice system and the juvenile justice system. So When we talk about community engagement, you know, Chatham has been a partner, you know, aside from me being, you know, alumni as well as a trustee, has been a partner of Gwen's Girls in the work that we do. But again, back to that question of why Chatham and why I chose to come to this university, it aligns with all the mission and the values that we espouse at Gwen's Girls. And so this was a picture of my mom, and unfortunately she passed away in 2007, and but we were able to still continue her legacy and the work that she started. So here is the mission of Chatham. I should have had a gift card for this one to see who could tell me that. Maybe I'll have to come back and see who can tell me that. So, you know, the mission is to prepare its students to build lives of purpose, value, and fulfilling work. So, you know, I'm not gonna ask people to, you know, answer, but I need you all to ask yourself as you embark on this journey, you know, first of all, why did you choose Chatham? And then what is your purpose? What are some of the things that you want to see out of your education? Because you have to be actively involved in this process. So these were the core values, again, sustainability, women's leadership and gender equity, community engagement. Did I skip one? What did it get? And diversity and inclusion. Oh, it's out of order. You all need help with my PowerPoint skills. So learn that too while you're here. So I wanted to take a few minutes just to for you all to, you know, if you have not seen this already, to know just who are you? What is your class? What's the class of now 2022 coming in? But woo, the class of 2026. Woo! Y'all clapping already. Y'all can. So when I prepared this slide, you know, again, we have to get better. I'm going to get better. And even, you know, I did not ask, go back and ask for additional, you know, data. But, and I guess, I don't know how it was asked, but one of the things is this gender is male and female, but there may be somebody that feels that they don't fit in that category. So again, we want to be inclusive. But for sake of just the data that we have here, there are 307 of you as of the 2nd of August when I got this information. And then of that, about a third are male, and the rest are female, as you can see. But I see our men are going to be very, Lord, you're going to be something else. What's your name again? Get his name. He's ready. So the other piece is just looking at, you know, ethnicity and just the, you know, how people identify and the diversity, right? And so I think that Chatham has done a great job of reaching out and trying to recruit folks from all different ethnic backgrounds, countries, different, you know, international students. But I know Dr. Feingold will join me in saying we still have to do better. Right? We can do better. But part of that too is, like, I don't stand up here and say what we can do. I also challenge you all. You all have younger siblings, you have friends, you have other folks that, you know, if they're interested in coming to Chatham, to tell them about your experience and, you know, help us recruit more people that maybe look like you, especially those of us that are in the minority. And then last but not least, which I think is, you know, significant also, you know, we wanted to look at, like, how many of you have had family members that have, you know, come and pursued a degree. And to my surprise, there's a lot of you that are not first generation folks that are, you know, pursuing your degree. So, and then there are, as I said, let's, here we have 53, and then there was three were no responses. So, You know, that's significant because that also helps us to understand, you know, sometimes when people haven't had anyone in their family that has pursued a degree or doesn't understand what's happening in a college setting, it may be a difficult transition for them. But as I look out and see you all in here, I see that we have some brilliant students and some young people that are going to be embracing the values that we just talked about. And I am encouraged about being not only alum or a trustee, but a fellow citizen of this county with you, and encourage you to get involved in anything that you see and hear going on your campus. Because it not only impacts you and those that are on this campus, but the region in general. So last but not least, I'm gonna wrap it up. And as I said, congratulations for just pursuing your education here at Chatham. What I would like for you all to do is look around the room. Look around, you have sessions, another session later today, but take the time to meet at least one new person. Introduce yourself. As I said, if we would have had the space and the capacity, I would have had you all go around and at least meet one person to do that. But again, as Dr. Feingold said, get involved. The only way that you will, you know, be able to really understand what's going on is if you get involved. And last but not least, make a difference. While you're here, take on a challenging issue or something that you see that needs to be done. Doesn't mean that you have to be the only one doing it, but there's other people that I believe that will support you in whatever efforts that you try here. But at the end of the day, I encourage you all in whatever you do to make a difference. So any questions for me? Thank you for your time and your attention. So do me proud, and when in your next session, I believe they're going to ask you the core values. I don't think they're going to have gift cards, so don't get too excited. But please remember those, because those are very important to your legacy here at Chatham. Thank you.
All right, everyone, I'm gonna let you out of here, don't worry. My name's Amanda Oaks-Chrisman. I'm the one all of you have been told to email with questions, so if that name sounds familiar, that's why. I just wanted to quickly go over what the schedule is for the rest of the day while I have you all here, just so you know what's happening next. So once we dismiss out of here, you're gonna get back into your orientation groups. As Dr. Elliott said, you're gonna talk a little bit about those core Chatham values, what those mean to you, and how you can enact them as part of our Chatham community. After that, you're gonna go to dinner, everyone's favorite, right? Time to eat. And then in the evening, we do have some events for you. There is a bingo night that's happening I believe it's outside. Let me double check here. Yeah, bingo night is gonna be in Mellon. And you can check your orientation schedule. That link is on the QR code that you scanned this morning. We also have some paper copies in the Office of Student Affairs. If you have any questions, ask your orientation leader. They'll be able to help you out and let you know where to go next. Yes. I'm really sorry it's loud in here. I can't hear you. I can talk to you afterwards, or if you want to speak a little bit louder. It is Pittsburgh Bingo Night, so you're going to find out what that means when you get there, but they're all going to be Pittsburgh themed. It's going to be very exciting. All right. So get back in your orientation groups. Have a great rest of your day, everyone.